Welcome back, guys. So today I want to take a quick look at the brand new 8BitDo N30 2.4 GHz controller meant solely for the original NES. From what I've heard, you're also going to be able to use these 2.4 GHz controllers on the Analog Pocket, but that's yet to be seen, so we'll have to wait and find out with that. So I was waiting on these for a while. I've had this in my possession for a moment. They were supposed to come out alongside the Analog NT Mini Noir, and that got delayed, but I do have an NES that I could use this on, and I really loved their Bluetooth version in the past, so I still have one of those. What I want to do today is tear both of them down, this brand new N30 controller and the Bluetooth one, kind of compare the two, right? So as you saw, the controller in the box, I'll give you my impressions of how this feels in a moment. You get a little insert manual thing, just explaining the battery life. We have a 180 milliamp hour battery. Sounds fairly small, but it's not. You get 18 to 20 hours play time with that after about an hour to 2 hours charge time on a completely depleted battery. The little 2.4 gigahertz adapter fits snugly in my console. Very nice. Not struggling to push it in. Doesn't just flop out. Simply hit start on the controller and it pairs right to it. So that is very nice. So there's a couple little neat things with these. So just like the previous versions, you do have those turbos where you hit the top buttons, you got that turbo action. You just hear some turbo fireballs for you, right? Ryan, why not? Now I do have an high def HDMI mod in my system, and there's one little trick with this. So you have that menu button that's really meant for like the Analog NT Mini Noir and whatnot to go to the menu. But if you have this high def kit in your system, you could use that button. If you set your hotkeys to down and select, you could use that to go into the high def menu. So that's pretty cool. So comparing the two controllers here, they feel pretty much identical, but there is a big difference. Obviously, one's Bluetooth, the other one's 2.4 gigahertz, right? Never really had an issue with the Bluetooth controller. Always felt like latency was just fine. Not a huge deal, but you know, for sure with the 2.4 gigahertz wireless, latency will be a bit better there. But the biggest difference is the Bluetooth version, you have L and R buttons on an NES controller. That's freaking unheard of. Why would I need that? But it's there. It's there because the one thing with the Bluetooth version, it does have a lot of uses. You could use this on multiple systems than the Nintendo Switch or a Raspberry Pi and whatnot, whereas this 2.4 gigahertz version is just for the NES. So here's the board. Just open this bitch up really quick. And as you see, nothing crazy going on here. Just fairly basic stuff. Little tiny ass battery on the back, as you saw. Just that 180 milliamp hour battery. Now the Bluetooth version does have a bigger battery. We'll see that in a second. Here's the inside of the other shell with the buttons and the D-pad. I really just wanted to see what this looked like compared to the Bluetooth version. As the Super Nintendo versions, they did do some upgrades. They did do some changes. And I wanted to see if they did the same with this, but I never really had an issue with the Bluetooth version. So, you know, it'd be nice to see what's going on here, but the main difference I saw was between the screws. Oh my God, one's got a pointy tip, little like self-threading freaking screw, and the other one's a flat top. Big deal. Who cares, right? But I just wanted to point that out. Different screws for these two different controllers, but they do share a lot of similarities. Little spring action for the L and R buttons up top on the Bluetooth. As you see, we do have a bigger battery, larger capacity, but with that Bluetooth, you know, signal, it is sucking up that battery juice a bit more. So you're still going to get around about the same amount of play time. And really digging into this, the D-pads, the buttons, everything is identical. The pads, the connections for the buttons, everything is identical. You just have those L and R buttons on the top. A few little cutouts on here on the Bluetooth version, on the board, and the bigger battery. But as far as the feel goes, it feels identical. So as you see there, 480 milliamp hour battery on the Bluetooth version. Here's a little look at the adapters, the retro receiver versus the 2.4 gigahertz receiver. One is a little thicker than the other. 2.4 gigahertz one's a little smaller. You don't have a sync button because you don't need it. Controller just pairs to it. You're just good. Nothing really to worry about there. The Bluetooth one, you do have that button to sync it up because you could sync up other controllers to it. So one of the big things with that that's worth pointing out is, you know, if you're looking between these two, I love this controller, by the way. I don't know if I've said that in this video, but I freaking love this controller. They used to make a version, a Bluetooth version, that had the diamond formation for the buttons. And I know, ergonomically or whatever the hell you say, it's better for the thumbs, the way you grip shit. But for me, playing NES, I gotta have those horizontal buttons, man. That's the way I grew up playing it, and this controller really feels good to me playing these games this way. With, you know, replicas or, you know, new school versions of old school controllers, if they really have that same feel to me, I'm down in it, man. But if they're kind of off a bit, I mean, as far as the feel goes, I'm just like wiring back up using the original controllers. I think 8-bit though, they do an excellent job for the most part. I haven't had too many things to complain about with their products. And I think this new 2.4 gigahertz controller for the NES, if you're in the market for something dedicated just for the NES, this is definitely the way to go. You're looking at $25 for this controller with the receiver, and I think that's a damn bargain. I've bought a couple of them. I love the NES, play it all the damn time. The Bluetooth version, the N30 Bluetooth, on the other hand, I was cruising, you know, Amazon, and I'm not seeing them listed anymore for some reason. Maybe they're out of stock. Maybe I'm just not finding the listing, because I was trying to find what the price was. They still have the retro receivers, and the retro receivers go for anywhere between $20 to $25. And if I remembered when I first bought the Bluetooth N30s, they were around $30. Finding them on other shops, just listed across the internet, I've seen the Bluetooth version going for between $20 to $25. So, you know, if you're looking at the low end, about $40 total if you want to get the Bluetooth version with the retro receiver. So if you just want to use the controller for the NES, I mean, I would just say go with the 2.4G. Because you're saving a little money. Damn, that rhymed. Hell yeah, that's what I'm talking about. But if you want versatility, if you want to use a controller on the Nintendo Switch, you want to use it on the Raspberry Pi or various other devices, right? Then the Bluetooth version may be more up your alley. For me, I love having dedicated controllers for my systems. I know it kind of gets out of hand at times, having so many damn controllers, but I'm getting better at organizing them, getting rid of the stuff that I don't use. And these are definitely staying in my NES arsenal, my arsenal of gameplay controllers. Pretty much all I'm going to use. I have some dog bones, some original controllers. Always got to have those originals for these retro consoles. Some really nice shape original controllers, you know, set to the side just in case you ever need them. But these are my go-to right here. So really do appreciate you guys hanging out with me. If you are interested, I will have a link in the description for the N30 2.4G controller. If you haven't seen my review, my video, whatever the heck you want to call it, for the Super Nintendo version, I'll put a link down below as well. Take a look at that. Really do enjoy that controller. They improved that one quite a bit over the original Bluetooth version, so that was really cool. This one, on the other hand, there's really no improvements. It was just a solid controller to begin with, in my opinion. So there you go. Really do appreciate you guys. With that said, I will catch y'all next time. Peace out, bye-bye, and boom. Bye.